there, Keith McElwain and Paige Piskin here to tell you our story. We grew up in Merrick, and Merrick, I don't know if you know, it's in the south shore of Long Island, but Merrick Road acts as the train tracks. I grew up on the north side, and Paige grew up on the south side. South side is all about juicy couture and all the latest brands, where north of the train tracks and Merrick Road right there, it's the no-name sweatshirts, and it's the hats from Puerto Rico.
We've grown up a little differently from each other, and that is why we're so different and why we sometimes conflict a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, it's a decent sized backpack, but I mean, you know, my problem with it is it's full with clothes. Did you really need those clothes, Paige?
Well, we are going kayaking later, so I will need to change. It is imperative.
Glad I'm sleeving over that.
I've always hated being on the scene and always being in front of the camera.
If it was up to him, he'd rather you search on Google Keith McElwain and get his grandpa from 5,000 years ago.
I'd rather be climbing on a mountain or jumping out of
but
an airplane over there.
But you can't, Keith. It's the 21st century. So basically, I've been an artist my entire life. I've always been creative. And I was never really like an athletic, risk-taking kind of person. And basically, when I saw MySpace coming around and Facebook and this and that, I said, I can do this. I could take over this stuff. So for about 2 years straight, sat in my room eating chicken nuggets and fries and basically created an online presence where I had over 30,000 friends on MySpace, and then I met Keith.
Yeah, but what does 30,000 friends mean when you got chunk all over the place from the McDonald's?
Haven't you ever heard of Photoshop? Because he was so polite and kind and inspirational, I decided to start working out and changing my ways and eating organically, and I lost all 50 pounds.
So it was a little give and take of the situation, but I got involved in some of the social media stuff, and she became a little athletic, but, you know.
A little athletic? I run 6 miles a day now, dude. And I went skydiving once.
See, I like to go to the radical end of the spectrum. You know, I mean, my dad was a retired firefighter from New York City, and when the fire went up in the building, everybody was running away from the building, but he was running towards it, and that's what really inspired my entire life.
So I know radical may sound pretty cool, right? Everybody wants a radical boyfriend, because that means you're gonna have some fun.
Yeah!
No. I'm talking about psychopath. That's not radical. That's something's wrong inside here. He doesn't just go radical. He will just throw himself off the edge of a cliff into the ocean. Doesn't know. Maybe he might not even know how to dive, but he'll do it anyway.
Hey, this is the way down.
No, it's not, Keith. We gotta go around the other side. We can't go that way. Can't you read the sign? It says freaking don't go there. It's closed off. Keith, it's really scary when you're by yourself with somebody like that, because he'll just go off and do his own thing, and I might just be stranded out there.
You know, as I kind of move forward and kind of continue to push my barriers of the radical world, I continue to pull her along with me. But
yes,
on the other side of the chain, it's a tug of war, because she's constantly pulling me the other way and she's got me tweeting every day.
So when it comes to our relationship, I know we're both a little crazy. We're both a little weird. We may look like Barbie and Ken. We're absolutely nuts.
Well, Ken's got a little bit shorter hair than
myself. All right. Maybe Ken, maybe the homeless Ken.
The homeless Ken? You know, if I'm going to get on The Amazing Race, I'm going to have to just be followed by the camera.
Please, when we go on The Amazing Race, change your clothes.
I'm not wearing any logos.
You can't wear a dress shirt and a random Puerto Rico hat.
Listen, unless they have any rules about clothes, I'm wearing whatever I want.
Fine.
Listen, what I like about The Amazing Race is now I'm not going to be the one pushing her to do the radical things. You're going to be pushing her. The Amazing Race is going to be pushing her. And now I get to just encourage her to follow the rules. Anything. Skydiving.
Ziplining.
Helicopter. Whatever it is. Jumping now. Walking over buildings.
All right, but you're carrying the backpack.
No way. There's two backpacks. You're carrying both. Come on. I thought you were Mrs. Athletic now.
You can get the extra shoulder workout.
I see how it is. See this?
I think we should go back.
Wait, what was that, Fish?
I'm not biking down another hill because I'm not going to bike up another hill. I think we've gone downhill enough. We're not staying over here.
I think Paige is ready for lunchtime.